I had a very good message from the book of Mark, chapter 4, from the book of Mark, chapter 4, from verse 35 to 41. But when I just entered here, I just felt that God wanted me to change the message. And there is nothing good like moving and walking in the Spirit. There is nothing good like being led by the Holy Spirit. So I want to put my notes aside and just think as the Holy Spirit is leading me. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Huyu mkalimani wangu anaweza waambia, hiyo ni page moja, umeiona? Hiyo ni ingine. Na imejaa mafunuo na neno la Mungu. But when I just, as I sat down, I was feeling the Holy Spirit suppressing the notes that I had. And I know these are his people. What he wants his people to hear is what he wants them to hear. I have prepared a message called The Storms of Life. We've been praying with your mom. That the first time she sent me the prayer items and how we, the direction to pray for the conference, I watched her and told her, I have actually been trusting God and waiting on God for this day. But God is faithful. I just want to speak just a word that I feel in my heart. That is pitching our hope in the tent of hope. Our tent in the land of hope. Pitching our tent in the land of hope. Before I forget, I want to just say something. Women who are in the house, hallelujah. Today it is our day. Lastly, I was here, I said this thing. That when you are expectant like Mary, look for minded people who are called the Elizabeths. Who have gone ahead of you. And they can show you the way. They can show you how everything is done because they have already experienced it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Bible records that there was a certain woman. The servant of God Elisha was sent to a certain woman. A certain woman who had a son. He had two sons. I want Pastor to look for that scripture for me. And it came a time when the husband of the woman died. Women, we are blessed. Is there a woman in this house? Women, we are blessed. The Bible says of another woman with the issue of blood. And I can tell you, women have issues. Women have issues. My husband usually tells me, take care of the issues. I will take care of the matters. Hallelujah. It's just because of this woman who had the issue of blood. I respect every woman that wakes up every Sunday morning
with their children dragging them behind them and going to church. I respect you. Even this population, most of us are women. Woman, you have a special place in the heart of God.
Thank you.
mtumishi mwingine wa Mungu. And he's not married. Na hajaoa. But he's a very powerful man of God. Lakini ni mtumishi wa Mungu anayedumu kwa nguvu sana. He was saying that he had a certain man of God. Akasema alisikia kila mtumishi. A general in the kingdom. A general in the kingdom. Generali katika ufalme. And he usually tells the wife. Anamwambia mkewe. Please go to bed. Tafadhali enda kulala. I have paid your bride price.
And buy a packet of lollipops. And PKs.
lollipop, lollipop, ni lollipop, hallelujah. I will sell lollipops. And I can tell you, I will buy for 250. And they are 50 pieces. And I'm selling for $10. I make a profit 100%. And I've said for 1 or 2 days. I was at the multimedia university. And I tell you, no, I will not look for anyone's money because I got mine. Even if it is 250. Hallelujah. Doctors, it is time to arise. God has blessed you with your hands and with your money. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I would also go to Kigoma and pick jobs for that role. And after the lessons, I would say to my fellow students, 400
more.
Hallelujah. Let me tell you something. I was the head of praise and worship for 4 years. So imagine with 2,000 shillings, I have to commute from Rongai to school. It's around 3 kilometers. I need fare every day. I need to make my hair. I need to dress like the university girls, you know, so that I can feel good. Hallelujah. But with that small business that I had, it used to sustain me. If you could see me commanding 200 university students, I'm buying uniform for the praise and worship. After the noisy lollipop. Hallelujah. So doctors, do not get into bad company just because you need money. Do something. When Mary was told that he would conceive Jesus, the Bible says in Luke, and Mary arose in those days. Mary arose in those days. He was so blessed and highly favored are you. He was so blessed and highly favored are you. He did not know that that was the beginning of the troubles. Can you imagine men going to the synagogue just because you are told you are blessed and highly favored? And everyone knew that Mary and Joseph and the wedding committee. Out of the blues, Mary goes to the synagogue like this. If that is what favor looks like, it is scary. Mary was told, you are blessed and highly favored. And then he questioned, how will that be? The Bible says he was told, the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Has God ever spoken a word over your life? And then trouble began to align themselves towards you. Usiona Mungu amesema neno la nguvu juu ya maisha yako. Alafu baada ya neno hilo kuachiliwa, mashida zinakuja ni kama zimetumwa. That is what it happened for Mary. After she was told, blessed and highly favored. From this day, Mary Hallelujah. After God has spoken a powerful word, after God has spoken a powerful thing word in the church, you get home as a woman, and your husband tells you, utarudi kwa hiyo pastor mahali umetoka. That is what happened to Mary. She was told, you are blessed and highly favored.
Between your feet.
There's many men. Many. Hallelujah. Man, you need vision. You need to have a vision for your family. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is because I know God respects a woman. Because they are a conscious, relationship conscious people. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If Eve would have blamed the husband, maybe things would be different. I always think to myself, God, if I get to heaven, give me 1 minute to talk to Eve. Just give me 1 minute to get petty. Just give me 1 minute. I need to be petty. I want to ask him, was that fruit really that good? Hallelujah. But I know I want to talk about Mulimupia. Hallelujah. I would ask to ask him, was that thing really that good? Do you know how I was suffering in the delivery room? Just because of that thing. God may have given his judgment. But he's a merciful God. Fathers and mothers, I have a word for you today. Fathers, arise and take your position. Take your rightful position. You are supposed to be the head of the family. Let me tell you, I don't know how it works in your family. But in my house, it is me who has to push people to pray. Hallelujah. I tend to have to carry their own duvet. Hallelujah. So you'll scare baridi na tukumbuke tulisema tunaamka kuomba. Hallelujah. I know we understand you work so hard for us. At times you need to rest. But the grace is available. Arise and take your position as the head that God ordained you to be. It is true, women have issues. But we have realized it even when we have issues. God has given us a seed. A seed that is everlasting. Jesus is the seed that came to hit the enemy's head. I just said how women in the Bible did. Women in the Bible did. When women got fully drunk, wanawake walipofika mwisho kabisa, walienda kwa Yesu. The woman with the issue of blood. When she heard Jesus was passing, I can imagine maybe she was smelling so bad. Maybe we have so many issues. We have so many issues at work. The business is not working. Last time the husband told me I am useless. But I'm still arising because I have to go to church. I have to connect with Jesus, who is the giver of life. And that is the source of strength for us. When people are pushed against the wall, where do you run to? Where do you run to? Where do you run to for help?
Hallelujah.
It is time we arise and fight for our seed. Fathers, it is time to arise and seek God for our children. Do you know we have been brought up in the African way? But fathers, do not even say I love you. Hallelujah. Do you know one thing? One day I told my father, I love you. He laughed. And you know, you even say, Mangui. I say, Mangui. Hallelujah. Fathers. Fathers. One day she woke up.
Siku moja aliamka.
And she asked me.
Na akaniuliza.
Mom.
Mom.
Why am I not brown?
Kwa nini mimi si mweupe?
Ukweli kabisa. Imagine. I asked my husband. Uliambia mtoto nini? She told me nothing.
Nikamuuliza mjakazi wangu ulimwambiaje mtoto?
Because my daughter was listening me asking the girl.
Sababu alinisikia nikimuuliza mtoto.
She told me, "Mom, I was not told by that girl."
Akaniambia mimi sijaambiwa na aunty.
Yes, and I don't call them auntie in my house.
Oh.
They have a name.
Uh-huh.
And I've told them they are not your aunties, they are your big sisters.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I say women, we are not each other's enemy.
Nasema wanawake sisi maadui.
That girl that God has brought in your life.
Ambaye mtu wa Mungu anamleta nyumbani pako.
She has a purpose there.
Ana kusudi pale.
Let her know, grow knowing that. She's here for an assignment.
Akuwe akijua kwamba yuko hapa kwa ajili ya shughuli.
And you have an assignment in her life too.
Na unayo kazi ya kufanya.
So when my daughter asked me,
iko mtoto wako aliponiuliza,
"Why, mami, why am I not brown like you?"
Mami, kwa nini mimi si mweupe kama wewe?
I told her, "Because you look like daddy."
Nikamwambia sababu unafanana na baba.
And she said, "Wow."
Akasema, "Wow."
So every morning,
kwa hivyo kila asubuhi,
every morning,
kila asubuhi
for two. When she wakes up,
anapoamka,
before she goes to school,
kabla aende shule,
she knows she has to go and kneel beside our bed.
Anajua kwenda kupiga magoti,
and the father has to repeat it to her.
Na babake arudie kwake,
"You are the most beautiful thing that you have ever."
Baba wewe ndiye kitu kirembo sana.
You are so beautiful.
Wewe ni mrembo zaidi.
You look like me.
Unakaa kama mimi.
But you're a girl like mommy.
Lakini wewe ni msichana kama mama.
And she goes to school feeling so good.
Na anaenda shule akihisi vizuri.
Fathers,
baba,
it is time to arise.
Ni wakati wa kuinuka.
Let your daughter grow knowing.
Mtoto wako pia
tena I am beautiful.
Akijua ni mrembo.
If she doesn't hear it from you,
kama anasikia,
she will hear it from someone else. And she told me,
"Akaniambia,
Mom, from today,
Mom, kuanzia leo,
don't buy me trousers.
Usininunulie trousers."
Look at this. She was four years old.
Alikuwa na miaka minne.
And I'm wondering.
And ninashangaa.
Who's telling this child this before?
Nani anamwambia mtoto huyu vitu hivi?
And she told me, "Mommy, from today, I don't want trousers."
Akaniambia kutoka leo mimi sitaki trousers.
I want dresses.
Napenda linda.
And when you dress her in dresses,
unapombalisha marinda,
she goes holding it like this.
Anaenda.
And she says, "I am a princess."
Anasema yeye ni
princess. Everyone who lives just around us, she tells them, "My name is Princess Benda."
Anajiita Princess Benda.
And she tells them, "It is daddy that told me that."
Anasema ni daddy aliyeniambia
hapo. That girl would grow with so much confidence. So I was telling you the day I told my dad I love you.
Nilikuwa nakwambia siku nilimwambia babangu ninapenda.
I am the last born.
Mimi ndiye kifunga mimba.
And I am the one who can tell my father the things that the elders cannot.
Na ndio mimi ninayeweza kumwambia baba yale ambayo wakuu wangu hawezi kumwambia.
My dad is not yet born again, but he loves God.
Babangu hajaokoka lakini anapenda Bwana.
I am the one who can tell him some things which the elder sisters cannot.
Na mimi naweza kumwambia baba
on one of the Father's Day,
siku moja ya siku ya baba,
I called him.
Nikampigia simu.
To tell him that today is Father's Day.
Nikamwambia baba leo ni siku ya baba.
I want to celebrate you.
Nataka kukusherehekea.
You've been a wonderful father.
Umekuwa baba mzuri.
And he was like, "Weka nguo kwenye simu."
Nataka
nikupigia.
Weka nguo kwenye
simu. He did not want to hear that.
Hakutaka kusikia hivyo.
Then I just decided, message. And these were the words that I told him. You've been an amazing father. pleasant aspect. Because I was looking for a man like you. Let me tell you. Would you love your daughter to marry someone like you?
Prosper you. What am I trying
generation. Let us plan our children. Let us tell them. Changing the next generation by doing that. Let us not stay silent. Let us not stay silent. If we don't tell them, they will hear it in social media. If we do not tell them, they will be told on Facebook. If you don't tell them, someone will inbox them. Someone who is interested in their hips. Because we are interested in their destiny. As we invest in their eternity, let us invest in them. I know right now they are here at home for 6-7 weeks. Make a program. Every night you will be reading one verse. Let that grow with them. Even if you are like a tuition, we are bringing them to church. But the best foundation is found in the house. Their family is the first foundation. For the church to be stronger. For the church to be stronger. The family must be strong. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It is time we arise. It is time we arise and get into our rightful position. As a woman in your house, let this be your position. Let this be your position. When there is no house rent, let this be the best position. As a man in your house, when there is no food to eat, let this be the best posture. Let this be your favorite position. Let this be our position of power. Let this be the position where we draw our strength from. Let this be the position where we shape our children's destiny from. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Ningependa sote tusimame. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. May you help us that we will get to our rightful position. That we will rise and get to our rightful position. In the mighty name of Jesus, help us, oh God. May you release your grace, oh God. Even as the fathers, we will take our position. Even as our mothers, as the mothers, we will take our rightful position. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah.